referee looks at his watch. Any second now.
Hello! Welcome back to Want More Bet TV. My name's Will.
I'm Ollie.
And I'm Tom.
Now that the World Cup is finished, it's only right that we go through and make our team of the tournament.
Yes.
Lots of debate to be had. Put your teams in the comments. Yeah. This is who we think is the best possible team.
Yeah. What formation are we going with?
We're going to go with 3-4-3.
Yeah. Get the attackers in.
Attack, attack, attack.
No one.
3-4-3. You make a solid team.
Always pick the attackers.
I'm not being funny. I can see this team right now, and it's pretty bloody good.
There's a few controversial ones that won't get in, but we think this is good. Also, before we get into it, remember to subscribe.
Yes.
And like the video.
Yes. Do it now.
Comment below on if you disagree as well, or if you agree.
Okay. Right. Team then.
So actually, the first one, goalie, is quite controversial.
It is quite controversial.
Before we start, should we just say well done to France?
Yeah. Well done to France. Allez les bleus. We did say at the end we thought they would win it.
Yeah.
Valiant effort from Croatia.
Valiant effort.
Yeah. Well done.
But to be fair, in the World Cup final, France looked immense.
Yeah.
England wouldn't have.
Nah, England
would have got done.
Word on the street is the Croatians are still running. Unbelievable.
Yeah, and well done to Modric.
Yeah, it's
close. It looks so sad.
Well done to Modric.
What that?
Oh, it was sad, but it's a great award to get that. Okay,
anyway, okay, coming in.
Goalie.
Goalkeepers.
Who are we going for? Is it biased or not?
I don't think it's biased. I don't.
It's a touch biased, but I think he was unbelievable.
The cat.
We've gone for Jordan Pickford.
Unreal.
Obviously, Courtois got the Golden Glove.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I think it should have been closer for.
Yeah.
Because he was considered, but I think he was probably in the top three for who they considered.
Yeah. But I think if you look at how much they did for their team, not like
I agree.
Stats, yeah. like Courtois had obviously Alderweireld and company in front of him, which made it his life a lot easier.
Mm. Oh, definitely.
Like Pickford was picking them out from the top bins left and right.
No, some of the ones Pickford saved.
Oh,
exactly.
Where he sees it so late, he just moves so quickly.
Yeah, and he plays so far forward. Yeah. He came up with crosses. Swept up.
Yeah,
with the ball at his feet as well.
He clattered. Yeah,
he was to be honest, England haven't had an amazing goalie for a while.
Yeah,
where we can actually get behind him, Pickford.
He's class. Love it.
It was brilliant.
And I'd actually like to see what people who aren't from England thought of Pickford. Because we're not just being biased. He was unbelievable.
Yeah.
And before you all jump down our throats and go, you're biased, just have a look at the highlights.
Yeah.
Type in Pickford highlights of Colombia game.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Croatia game.
Saved the penalty as well.
Sweden game.
Three amazing
saves.
Made three really good saves. Other people that we could have had, Lloris.
Yeah. But then he
had a nightmare
in the final.
But it didn't really matter.
It didn't matter.
But he made a save in literally every game.
Yeah.
Like,
the one against Uruguay.
If you do have a mare like that, you can't really win the Golden Glove, can you? Because it's like...
True. Man. So we've gone for Pickford. It could have been Courtois, could have been Lloris.
Yeah.
We've gone for Jordan Pickford.
Yeah.
Okay, so then three defenders.
Cool.
Right.
Varane was unreal.
I mean, that one solid. If anyone disagrees with that, they are not football fans.
First defender on the sheet.
Unbelievable.
Great tournament.
Unreal. The game against
Belgium.
Yeah. He was like... He won every single hit.
Yeah.
He was immense.
He's a beast.
Absolutely immense.
I mean, everyone knew his class as well, but this tournament, he's really like kind of stepped it up.
Yeah.
I've always thought he's good, he's young, he's going to be amazing, but he's still
really young.
I honestly didn't realise how good he was on the ball, didn't realise how many headers he won, and he's a leader.
Yeah.
He was like bossing people around.
Yeah.
He's Varane. Everyone's got to agree with that one. Second one. Is
a bit biased.
Touch biased, but he's basically a national hero right now.
Oh, yeah.
Harry Maguire.
Oh, Harry Maguire.
Slabhead.
Slabhead. Basically, I don't know if you saw it, Jamie Vardy went into the press conference, put his hand up and went, "I'm Jamie Vardy from the Vardy Express." Is it true your head's this big to Harry Maguire?
Really?
So yeah, Harry Maguire had an unbelievable tournament.
He's another player which I think has completely just stepped up. And now everyone, I bet people don't really watch Prem.
Don't know who he is.
Now they know who he is.
He was brilliant. Class. Good on the ball. 2 years ago, he was with his mates
watching
England.
Yeah.
So that's why I just rate him. He's gone from that to probably, he was England's star player at the World Cup.
Most improved award.
One of.
Most improved?
Yeah, he was.
Most improved award.
Yeah. He was immense. Yeah, Rio Ferdinand even said in his commentary, didn't he? He was like, he was immense against Sweden, wasn't it?
Bullet header as well.
Oh, and then the header
FIFA,
as well.
Picked out five players to watch from the tournament.
Oh, right.
He wasn't in there.
What?
But one of the other names that we're going to have in a minute was from England.
Oh, okay. Yeah, fine.
Yeah.
So that's that. A little bit biased, but we thought Maguire had a really good tournament.
Yeah.
The third centre-back also made it to the final.
Yeah.
Centre-half for Croatia, Vida.
Yes.
Debatable Barnett,
but decent player.
Scored an important goal.
There's probably going to be a few people going, actually, you should have had this person instead of him, but...
There's a few others you could throw in the mix, but we've gone for Vida. Croatia got to the final. You've got to have
a rock.
Yeah, he was class.
He's solid, wasn't he?
And if you're playing next to Dejan Lovren, you've got to be a good player.
the best defender.
Lovren will say he's in it. Yeah. 100% he's going to comment.
Lovren was all talking three about. Centre backs. He thought he was so good. Other people you could throw, Godin from Uruguay, but we've gone Varane, Maguire.
Jimenez was good.
And Vida, that's
good.
True.
Jimenez was good.
But then, we've got those three.
Then, right mid.
Yeah.
Kieran Trippier.
What a player. So, he was the one on FIFA's list.
Yeah, I'm not
He was unbelievable.
Yeah.
His delivery was amazing, pacey, intelligent.
Yeah.
Well, England scored 9 goals from set pieces, didn't they?
Yeah.
And he took pretty much all of them.
He's probably got
three or four assists.
You can see the comments right now coming in. Oh, England.
Yeah.
But I don't care. Even everyone must agree with Trippier.
Yeah.
Maybe not Pickford, maybe not Maguire.
Agreed.
Trippier, if you don't think Trippier should be in that team,
then you need to watch it again.
You need to put your glasses on.
The free kick was class.
Was it Charlie Nicholls?
Beckham-esque.
He's got his
Was Beckham-esque, that free kick.
Yeah.
His delivery
every delivery he put in looked like we're going to score. And it's half because of him and half because of the old love train.
I'm pretty sure I read a stat that he created more chances than anyone else
in the World Cup. The group stages, but maybe in the whole World Cup.
No, I think it is 24 chances he created in the World Cup. I'm pretty sure I read that.
Yeah.
So that's why. Got to be Trippier right back.
Yeah.
Left mid,
Cheryshev.
From Russia,
who I actually think is probably, what would you call it, the person who has gone from really unknown to one of the...
He's announced himself.
Wasn't even starting.
The biggest target. No, he wasn't. The first game, he didn't start.
Yeah. Wow.
And he came on to score.
So then he started every other game.
Ridiculous finishes.
But he's probably the one that I would say has done the best personally.
Agreed.
Out of this World Cup.
Yeah. I agree.
He has to be in the team. He was ridiculous. Every goal he scored was ridiculous.
Yeah.
Insane touches. The one against Croatia. Was it Croatia?
Yeah.
Where he's bent it was an unbelievable.
And in the first game.
Both goals in the first game.
Yeah. Well, brilliant.
He scored 4 and 5 in the end.
Yeah, he scored 4 goals.
Yeah.
I mean, he can't not be in there.
No, he's in there.
He was unreal. 100%. Centre mids. These could be controversial. Well, one's not.
Go for the one that isn't controversial first.
The one that isn't controversial, Modric.
Modric.
And I don't actually think the other one's controversial either.
It is when you compare him to the person that could,
that
be
could go in. Okay, so Modric is the first one.
Yeah.
He won the Golden Ball.
Yeah.
Best player in the tournament.
Yeah.
I mean, what a few months that guy's had.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Won the Champions League for, 3 years in a row.
Yeah.
Won the World Cup. Got to the final of the World Cup and won the Golden Ball.
Yeah, and he's probably still underrated.
Yeah.
He's still so underrated.
He's so good.
Against England, it was just him and Rakitic just making Croatia tick.
We knew that would happen though.
And I just thought it was amazing.
Yeah,
he's a class player.
Okay, so then the other one we've gone for, Pogba.
Le Pog.
Who I did think pulled the strings.
He looked very good.
Hair-splitting passes.
Oh, unbelievable. through to Mbappe.
Mbappe, which caused the goal.
Pogba's goal.
Yeah.
But people forget about those little moments. They think it's an accident. He just
that was it.
Unbelievable passes.
I've always questioned Pogba, but when I see him playing for France like that, I'm like, he's a monster.
And also,
he's so strong. He can do everything.
In terms of team morale, want him in there.
Oh yeah.
Because he's probably
like stabbing with the president.
Oh, he's just
in terms of morale, he's probably your first one on there.
So the other person that could be in there is
Kante.
He could have been in there.
Yeah.
He didn't. Well, he struggled in the final, didn't he? Came off after like 50 minutes.
Mm. Probably because he's done so much running.
Yeah, I mean,
already
he's ridiculous. But we've gone Pogba and Modric centre mid.
Let us know if we've missed anyone out of centre mid.
Yeah. And then the three strikers.
Yeah.
First one, like on my left, we've gone Eden Hazard.
You can't not put him in there.
He was class.
He ripped teams to shreds, and you could not get the ball off him.
No.
Literally cannot get the ball.
It's like Velcro.
Against Brazil, in the first half against Brazil, he was unreal.
Yeah.
He was unplayable.
No, and France.
France, yeah, fair. He was just unplayable. Yeah. He's so good. He's so strong.
Yeah.
And he's just...
And his change of direction. Yeah. I'll be absolutely
gutted if he's not playing in the Premier next year.
I think he's not... I think I'm pretty sure he'll go to Real.
I'd be very surprised if he doesn't go to Real Madrid.
Yeah.
Like, he was...
Apparently Chelsea are trying to get the checkbook out now to get him to stay like 330 grand a week.
Really?
I just don't think it's money for him.
He wants a different... He wants
needs a new challenge.
Yeah.
I think Hazard was so good. He was just unplayable. Yeah. Unplayable. And then on the right side...
Mbappe.
Can't not. Those two have to be in there.
Oh, mate, Mbappe.
Mbappe is so
there's a lot more to come from him. He's 19,
mate. Right. I mean...
But the amount of hype that is on him now.
Oh.
Yeah, but I think there was hype on him before, and he's delivered.
Yeah, he's delivered.
Yeah, he's just unreal.
But he doesn't seem to have
made him. He's like the shining superstar that's come out of the tournament. Everyone, he was already up there, obviously.
But he did what Neymar did a while ago, where everyone was like, Neymar, and then he had quite a good tournament.
Mm.
Yeah.
But Mbappe.
Yeah. I mean,
He was up there for the player of the tournament.
Yeah.
Against Argentina, he ripped them to shreds, didn't he?
Yeah.
He was just unplayable. Yeah. And that little bit of skill.
Yeah. Oh, that 1-2.
This is only going to do well for his confidence as well. I think he's going to go back. If he has an amazing season now, he's up there. He's like, he's taken over from Ronaldo.
He's going to take over from Ronaldo.
Henri Mark 2.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he's just got more skill as well.
Yeah.
And then striker.
Striker, I mean...
I'm not sure about the thing. He's won the Golden Boot. Yeah, but he's won the Golden Boot from few pens, dodgy headers.
But also, when the pressure was on, he took his chance.
Still not scoring.
Yeah, against shit teams.
There's probably one chance that he didn't score, which cost us.
Yeah, the one that he hit the post.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know, someone's played that back from a different angle, and it's actually an incredible save. Do you know that?
Really?
Ooh, no, I've not seen that.
The keeper gets like a stud to it, which pushes it, which changes the direction of the post. Yeah.
From
behind.
You can't knock that. To score 6 goals at the World Cup is epic.
Yeah, he's
great. Right, I know he didn't score them against the best teams, but Lukaku played against them teams.
Yeah.
Lukaku didn't do it. Lukaku's touch.
Yeah, but ours was set pieces.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter.
He didn't actually create... like a decent, like, taking on a player and slotting the back.
That's not what he's for, though.
But Harry Kane, the goal against Tunisia, the header in the last minute, is the reason that he's there.
Yeah.
And he's the tournament top scorer. You can't knock that. Taking the pen against Colombia, loads of pressure on it.
Yeah.
I just think 6 goals,
you
want to strike, your striker's there to score goals, and if he had Hazard and Mbappe next to him,
he'd have scored 10 goals.
He'd have scored more than that. Yeah. So there's just one player that I'm actually gutted we've missed because I thought he was unbelievable. Perisic.
Yeah,
Perisic from Croatia
last.
But
that's a team.
He goes in there instead of Hazard or
Cheryshev maybe left mid, but he's more of a striker. Oh, I don't know. I mean, Perisic.
Too much talent.
There's so many players had amazing.
Yeah.
Pavard from France.
Yeah, Pavard. Mm. Pavard is probably the next name that I would have in there.
Yeah, I agree.
But does he would be instead of Trippier. And I think Trippier was better.
Trippier was
I agree.
Up. So,
I mean, he's a centre-half, really, Pavard, but...
And then I think the one that you said, which was a bit of an outsider, he shouldn't have got in there, but he actually had a great tournament. Lozano.
Yeah. From Mexico.
From Mexico.
Yeah.
Every time he got the ball, they looked dangerous.
They looked dangerous.
He obviously wouldn't get into this team, but he's a... Like,
he'll be on the
worth
bench.
A mention.
He'll be on the bench.
Yeah.
Worth a mention.
So that's our team. If you think you can do better, put them in the comments. We want to see. If we've missed anyone, make sure you get them in the comments.
Yeah.
Who
would your subs be?
Oh yeah, who would your subs be?
And your manager.
Yeah.
And your manager. Gotta be Southgate. I have to be Southgate.
I
surely.
Mean, Southgate was the most stylish.
Yeah.
I mean, sold out waistcoats.
100% Southgate.
And that's it. That's our team of the World Cup.
Cool. 2018. All right. Actually, wait. Before we go, worst players.
Flops.
Biggest flops.
One flop. I go with Robert Lewandowski.
Oh, he's number one.
Yeah.
Flop.
100%. I thought he basically just didn't turn up.
Yeah.
Poland didn't turn up. Nah, but neither did he.
But yeah. If your team aren't turning up, you need your best
your
player
yeah, to step up.
Step up.
To get a goal.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. That's why Kane was in there for England. Stepped up when he needed to. May not have played unbelievably, but scored the goals.
Yeah.
For me, Lewandowski was the biggest flop.
Neymar.
Ooh. Neymar was a flop. We said before the tournament, this is his tournament.
Yeah.
We said this is his.
If you compare Neymar to your average player, he played well. If you compare Neymar to Neymar, who and his expectations was like up there with Ronaldo's Messi. Messi as well, didn't have a great tournament.
Yeah, fair.
But Ronaldo stepped up to the plate, smashed them in.
Yeah.
Neymar just diving, he was diving around all over the place, more than usual.
Yeah.
Like, I mean,
Jesus
play some football.
I was just about
Jesus
to say,
as well.
Gabriel Jesus for me.
Didn't score one.
Didn't score goals. I mean, he worked his hard, but whenever Firmino came on, Brazil looked better.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it was just the manager just stuck with Jesus.
Yeah.
I think that's a good shout.
Yeah.
Jesus. Neymar. Well,
the other one who people probably thought would have done better, but his team just didn't allow him to play well. Salah.
No, I think that was the injury.
Yeah.
He wasn't going into people. Yeah,
I think it was injury.
If he was 100% fit,
and he still scored.
He would have pulled him through.
Stats-based, Giroud didn't have one shot on target.
Oh, hold on a sec. Didn't we have a bet before the tournament?
Here we go.
You got that cash?
50 quid, mate.
Yeah,
50 quid.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to go and get it out.
So I said Mbappe would outscore Giroud. He bet me 50 quid. That wouldn't be the case. Mbappe, a pretty good World Cup, didn't he?
Yeah.
Mbappe, I think he just beat Giroud.
Yeah, just about.
I think Giroud.
But even though Giroud didn't have a shot on target, he's there to play off.
He's there
to play off. So
there you go.
He can't.
He was pulling strings, is what you're saying. Yeah.
One more question. Which team overperformed compared to what they expected?
Croatia.
And which team massively underperformed? I think we know who that is, though.
Croatia. Well, we said that I thought they would be dark horses and they were very good. But little shout out to Japan.
Yeah.
I think
if you compare like the benchmark to where they've got, I think Japan would probably be up there.
And Russia.
And Russia, yeah.
Japan, Russia, and Croatia. I think all of those overperformed.
Yeah, those three.
Japan, I loved watching Japan. Against Belgium, I thought they were
it's a good time to just apologise to the Japanese.
Sorry.
Because we got that completely
every
wrong.
Every game, we're like, nah, this time.
We said you were a terrible team, but everyone did.
Before the World Cup, they ranked like 61st in the world.
Yeah.
Just got a new manager in. They had no form going into it. And then they were unbelievable.
And then with Russia, you've got to remember that they got that home advantage.
Yeah.
And that really helped them. They were playing so bad before the World Cup.
Yeah.
During the World Cup, different side.
Oh,
it'd be interesting to see whether any doping thing comes out about that, because apparently they ran further and like faster than anyone else for longer.
Wow. Yeah.
And it's like, hold on, if you compare, like, this is like an outlier on the stats.
Yeah, but they needed that. We needed them to do.
But we'll let them have that. We'll let them make that ball. We'll let them have it.
As long as they didn't knock England out, it's fine.
Yeah.
And then I think the biggest flopping team has to be Germany.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah,
100%. Closely followed by Argentina, I think.
But the thing is,
I
didn't actually expect Argentina to do
well. Germany.
Yeah,
we thought Germany would still do okay.
Yeah,
they'll get through this.
Something.
Oh, Germany smashed qualification.
Yeah. They something must have happened behind the scenes.
Yeah, Sané.
No Sané
must have caused the rift.
But there was that's the reason. It was an attitude thing. It wasn't like he was injured or anything.
Mm. But Sané's sitting at home going,
"Told you,
what is going on?
Told you."
I missed.
Yeah, he would have been so good at the World Cup as well.
Oh. Could have been a completely different story.
And Mbappe could have been up there with Mbappe.
Yeah.
What a shame that it wasn't there. But we'll see. Right. We'll see him at the Euros.
Yeah.
Right. That is it. Get your comments in the comments. Hit the like button. Hit subscribe. And we'll see you next time.
See you later.
Now then, the referee looks at his watch. Any second now.